So is it true? Do we finally have a cure for visual snow syndrome? Today, we're going to be taking a look at some newly published research which looked at using NORT, which stands for Neuro-Optometric Rehabilitation Therapy, and its efficacy as a treatment for visual snow. Plus, stay tuned because we'll also share some tips on how to find a specialist who could offer you this sort of treatment. Let's take a look. Hey, how's it going there, my friends? Dr. Joseph Allen here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, helping you learn everything about the eyes and keeping you seeing your best. So first off, what is visual snow? So if you're new here to the channel, or if you've never heard of visual snow syndrome before, visual snow syndrome is a complex and largely misunderstood neurological condition, but it presents with visual disturbances. Most notably is that of your vision kind of blanketed by these moving spots or flashing white dots that sort of resembles snow or something kind of like the static you'd see on an old TV set, or as if with a newer camera you jacked up the ISO super high and that makes everything kind of look grainy. And people see this all of the time. Even if they close their eyes, they can still kind of see this static going on. Now, the symptom of visual snow can be something extremely mild, such as what I personally have experienced since I was maybe about 9 years old. It's very subtle, enough so where it doesn't really bother me. However, if I really kind of zone out and look around me, yeah, I can see it. I'm aware that there's like this static on everything. But however, for some people, it can be really extreme to the point where some people, they can't even really function. They can't see to read, they can't see to drive, and even do some just basic activities of living. Now, visual snow syndrome also presents with other neurological symptoms, and I've gone over those more thoroughly, as well as the proper diagnosis of visual snow, and I've done that in a previous video, and you can check that out here. But however, we have this new research that's out, and specifically uses NORT. What is NORT, and what did the study find? In this new study, which was published just at the end of 2022, took about 21 participants, which is a smaller study, and they had them go through about 12 weeks of NORT, which again stands for Neuro-Optometric Rehabilitation Therapy, which if you've never heard of NORT before, is really just a fancier way of saying vision therapy. Now, if you're unfamiliar, vision therapy and something called orthoptics are basically just different forms of eye muscle exercises. Orthoptics is sort of used in the industry more to describe treatment and use of these eye muscle exercises as a therapy for binocular vision issues, such as somebody having double vision, and doing these eye muscle exercises to get the brain to use the muscles a little bit better of the eyes to correct that problem of double vision. Whereas vision therapy, which I think has historically been used a little bit longer, but in more recent years has sort of shifted to describe the use of these eye muscle exercise therapies to treat things outside of even just standard visual conditions. And some practitioners even use them as a treatment for other a wide variation of conditions and symptoms, such as helping with traumatic brain injury, for example. Now, this study did use a pretty wide range of eye muscle exercises, but some of these exercises, if you've never seen them before, are pretty cool. So let me just kind of show you some cool, interesting ones so you have a better idea of what's going on. For example, some of these exercises work on your accommodative and vergence muscle control. This is where you may look through certain lenses at a near object, and you can see through the lenses things are very blurry, and that forces you to use your eye muscles to focus through and clear that image. Then they'll switch those lenses to something that then makes those letters really blurry again, and you have to relax your eye muscles to clear it up. And then they kind of go back and forth, and this trains your eye muscles to be able to focus better and relax easier, kind of like learning to lift weights with your arm and then relax it again, doing that over and over. Another type of exercise could be for saccadic eye movements, where you're able to look around from side to side, darting your eyes from one object to the next, and just having more precise control and wider and shorter ranges of movements. And then there are even fusion exercises, such as this lifesaver card here. This is where you will have like a red object and a green object that kind of look like lifesavers. But the challenge with this type of card is that you try to kind of go cross-eyed, and then you can bring those two object images together till it forms kind of a flashing red and green lifesaver that appears to lift off of the paper. And then the challenge comes from looking at the different lifesavers that are appearing because they're spaced apart differently, and that'll challenge you to use a wider range of your eye muscles. And this also trains your ability to control those eye muscles really well. Now, in many ways, I am just simplifying kind of the explanation of some of these tests. There are a plethora of different eye muscle exercises used in this study and exist in vision therapy, orthoptics, and NORT. So if you want to know more detail of what some of these sort of exercises are, I will, of course, they list it out in the study, and I will put a link to the full study if you want to read it yourself in the description below. But again, for this study, they had the participants go through a 12-week program that included having a one-hour session every week with a vision therapist or an eye doctor who would help them go through these eye muscle exercises and challenge them, making them harder and harder. And then they would also have them throughout the week do different kind of homework and do a lot of these vision therapy techniques on their own at home. So, what did they find? First, the most important thing I think people should understand when they're looking at this study is that they did not have improvement in people's visual snow symptoms. Like, it didn't wipe away the snow or the static symptoms. They reported no significant improvement in people's ocular health, ocular pain, color vision, or peripheral vision. However, what they did report was not only improvements in visual function scores for distance and near vision, but they also reported statistically significant improvements in social functioning, mental health, role difficulties, and dependency, along with improvements in overall quality of life. And although I wouldn't call it a cure for visual snow by a long shot, it sounds like there are a lot of benefits here. And I say this because so many people with visual snow struggle with just daily activities in their life, whether it be work, study, or using their phone or computer screen, even driving, and then going out and doing social activities. These can all be affected by their visual snow symptoms. So if we can improve somebody's eye coordination and improve their overall focus and decrease or dampen their symptoms to a point where it improves their quality of life and all of their activities, that's a huge win. And I can tell you just from my personal experience for the patients who've come to seek me out asking about visual snow and getting a diagnosis, it feels good for me to finally have something to be able to offer to my patients that there could be something to help them. Otherwise, in the past, there's very few, if not any, real treatments or ways to really help people with visual snow. So I'd love to ask you, what do you think about the findings in this study? If you have visual snow syndrome, would you want to go through 12 weeks of vision therapy or NORT in order to improve your kind of quality of life, knowing that it wouldn't get rid of your visual snow symptoms? Especially for a 12-week program of vision therapy or NORT can cost usually a couple thousand dollars, like $2,000 to $5,000 to go through that length of a therapy. Would it be worth it for you? Please let me know in the comments. Now, for those of you who are watching this and have visual snow and you're like, yes, I've tried so many things, I'm excited to try this, even if anything that can help, I want to go through this. How do you find a doctor or a clinic that is offering these sort of services? First, I do just want to call out the end of the study and the conclusion. They did say that they need to do further research on this and just recognize it was a smaller study of about 21 participants. And they found a lot of the participants had binocularity vision coordination issues to begin with. So, not surprising that they had some improvement with these different exercises. There's also a good chance that a lot of doctors and researchers may have not even read this study and don't quite know about it. So, one way you can find doctors or a clinic that may be willing to offer this and try to help you out, first, I would recommend going to what is called the NORA website. This stands for Neuro-Optometric Rehabilitation Association. These are usually doctors who specialize a little bit more on the neuro side of things, things that involve the brain, people who've had traumatic brain injury, all of those sort of things. But if you do go to their website, they do have a search engine for doctors who are part of that association. And so you can type in your area code or search for a doctor that may be in your area that offers vision therapy or NORT as a possible treatment. I think that might be a great place to start. Otherwise, you may have to just call around to different clinics in your area, ask them first if they offer anything like vision therapy, and if they've ever done previous work with people who have visual snow syndrome, or if maybe if they've even heard of this study, and maybe they'd be willing to read into the research, into this study, and being able to offer it to you as a possible form of treatment or therapy. I think as long as people are willing to accept, hey, this is one study, it's a smaller study, it's a little anecdotal, but again, if there's no real risk of being hurt or if there's no real problem with it and you've been suffering with this, anything could help. Hey, thank you so much for watching the video, sticking around toward the end. If you are new here to the channel and you haven't subscribed already, kind of like, you know, 90% of our viewers, please do me a favor, hit that subscribe button, turn on the bell to be notified of new videos that are coming out. And if you have further questions, anything about the eyes you want to learn, again, let me know and we'll talk about it. Keep an eye on it. We'll see you in the next one.